in that one word.
I couldn't have said it better myself.
And this is what the relationship of an Islamic believer is: a total submission,
to
a
him.
Total commitment, a total resignation of self to this greater, and doing it, as you say, in sincerity, and sa'alam, in peace. All of that is...
The peace that we're talking about, a lot of times I hear Muslims say Islam is peace, and that's not really right. That's wrong to say that, because it doesn't mean the kind of peace like that we'd like to see, peace in the Middle East,
yeah,
peace between brothers and so on. But this is the kind of peace that you have in your life, that no matter what is sent to you from him, you're at peace. Now, there's two extremes here. Suppose somebody has all of the material things that come at them very fast, like winning the lottery or something like this, and then said, oh my God, I can go crazy, right? So that's not peace. So if I was given these great riches and wealth of this world, but to be in peace and say, this too shall pass.
Yeah.
This isn't going to be forever. Then the other side of it, that when these calamities and disasters come to a person, but they're in peace with it, and they say, this too shall pass.
Yep.
That's
yep.
the middle road that we're looking for.
Yep.
Now, whoever does this would be called an Islam-er, because that'd be the verb.
Yeah.
Yeah, Islam-er or Aslama, and then he's an Islammer. Well, we don't use suffixes in Arabic language. We use prefixes for the verb. So instead of like walk, talk, think, stink, like that. I'm sorry. Anyway, they use the prefix mu. So it would be mu'adhin, the one who calls the prayer, mu'safar, the one who travels, and mu'islam.